Let's talk a little bit about the difference between get and post. We've already seen one of the differences, and that's get parameters are included in the URL, and post parameters are included in the body. Another difference is that get requests are often used for fetching documents, and get parameters are usually used to describe which document we're looking for, or maybe what page we're on, or things of that nature. Basically, things that are describing, you know, what we're getting. Where post parameters are often used for updating data, for actually making changes to the server or to the data held on the server. Another difference is that get parameters, because they're in the URL, have a maximum URL length, or they're affected by the maximum URL length, because you can only encode, you know, so many parameters. For example, I think Internet Explorer allows 2,000 characters in the URL or something like that, which can be quite limiting. Posts, by default, have no maximum length. Now, the server can be configured, and most are, to have a maximum length, but it's usually substantially longer than 2,000 characters. You know, it's probably a few megabytes. Another difference is that get parameters are generally okay to cache. And when you make a get request, a simple request for a URL, there's a good chance that it's been cached. There are a lot of machines between you and the server, or often there are, and it saves a lot of effort if we know the document hasn't changed to, you know, cache it along the way so you don't have to, you know, request it new every time. Post parameters are almost never cached. That's because you're probably updating data on the server. And so the industry standard is don't cache post requests. One more difference is that get requests, you know, because they're okay to cache and because you're usually describing, you know, which document you want, they shouldn't change the server. You should be able to make the same get request over and over, and the server shouldn't change. Post requests, on the other hand, are okay to change the server. That's what they're generally used for, is requests that update the server. That's why they're not, you know, cached, there's no max length, and, you know, that's the whole story. So in short, get requests should be simple requests for fetching a document, and get parameters should be used to describe what document or what page you're looking for. And post parameters are used for making updates to the server. And post requests generally are, you know, destructive in nature. Now, if you don't follow these rules, you can get into a little trouble.